Greetings, it's New Zealand naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher. Thanks for checking out my video. We're going to talk about testing for SIBO. So small intestinal bowel overgrowth. How do you test for it? How do you know you've actually got this bug? If you look at the signs and symptoms, you may identify with some of those that we've spoken about. But what are some of the medical tests we can do to determine, you know, the accuracy of our own personal diagnosis? Well, there are many tests you can do. Breath tests have been used traditionally for some time now to measure hydrogen or methane gas, that are produced by these bacteria inside. So if we breathe that out, we can measure that. But these are notoriously inaccurate. And I've actually given up on these tests now because I find many people, in fact, come back with false results. So they can produce methane, they cannot produce methane. It's not necessarily 100% ironclad guarantee that they will have these bugs, or even exactly what bugs we're dealing with. A more accurate way to test for SIBO is a stool test. It's a much more accurate way. When we take stool samples on three concurrent days, we can actually culture the stool, we can do microscopy, so we can actually look at the stool through a microscope, and we can actually culture it in a lab in dishes, petri dishes, to see what we can grow out of it. It's a much more accurate way. When you do these kind of tests, you're better off not having any pharmaceutical medications or dietary supplements that can influence the bowel. Generally for about a week prior, I prefer to work like that. And I usually let the patient eat what they feel like eating, because that way we're going to get a more true representation of what's really in the digestive system. So the first page I look at will be the bacterial panel to show me the beneficial, the commensal, and the dysbiotic, the three types of bacteria there. So you should have lots and lots of high levels of all the healthy bacteria, the E. coli, lactobacillus, the bifidobacteria, the various bacteria that should come back with 3 or 4+ in a healthy stool, in a stool test. Many people come back at very low levels. Enterococcus is another species I see. There are many species. So we shouldn't really see any dysbiotic bacteria. We shouldn't be able to culture any bad ones. But with SIBO, we often culture multiple species of bad ones. The next thing I look at will be the immunoglobulin, secretory IgA, and that should be a healthy level. And we often see that at rock bottom levels with people with SIBO. And if we want to look further, we can look at many other pages on the stool report to determine many other factors. So this video is not really about stool testing, but it's about testing for SIBO. So what you want to do also is clearly understand that many people with chronic candida actually have chronic SIBO and candida concomitantly. They have both of these infections combined. And that's a real problem with some people, particularly people who've had antibiotics recurrently. This is what I commonly find. Antibiotics will actually allow candida to thrive and also kill off the beneficials, allowing the dysbiotic bacteria to come back again along with the candida. So they have a whole mixed match of different types of bugs in their system. So the worst case scenario when we do stool tests is multiple candida species, low beneficial bacteria cultured, and high amounts of dysbiotic bacteria. Those are truly difficult cases to work with. And it's taken me years of experience to try and work out how to deal with these patients. For that reason, one of the reasons why I developed up my own range of CanXida products to deal with these types of patients. I'm going to do some videos shortly on why I don't agree with prebiotics as part of dietary supplements. In fact, I just listened to a very interesting podcast from Dr. Seebecker, the SIBO specialist in America, who agrees with me that prebiotics are not a good idea to add in with probiotics. And when I developed CanXida Restore, I purposely left inulin and FOS and these other sugars out, unlike other brands like Syntol and 3-Lac and Floracore GI, all these products, they actually put prebiotics in. And I've given up using those products now because I've just found people with SIBO react too much to these products. So just be careful what you're taking. If you've got SIBO, avoid prebiotics. But testing, have a good think about it. Do my Candida quiz. That might give you an idea on Candida and dysbiosis in general. But generally, you don't need to do a test to determine if you've got SIBO. A good idea for you is to take a good antifungal product to see what happens. That will be a good step in the right direction. And if you start getting improvement, you know that you will have wiped up some bad bacteria. You can do the methane or the hydrogen breath test if you want. But, if you come back with negative, it's not necessarily a positive for, that you've got no bugs. I think the best way really is to treat. If you've got the gut feeling you've got SIBO, just treat. Take a good antifungal like my CanXida Remove product. Just take that for a week or two and you'll soon know if you've got SIBO or not. Hope this video was some use to you today. Thanks for tuning in.